Welcome to Memorial Stadium in Berkeley, the home of the California Bears, one of the big stories in college football this season. And today, the 13th-ranked Bears play host to the Ducks of Oregon. Cal wins today their best start in 30 years, and they arguably have the best offense in the West. They have so many weapons.
They're unbelievable. Everywhere you look on that offensive unit, they're capable of scoring touchdowns, short range, long range. Taking them a number of years under Bruce Snyder to build up this team, but with the multiplicity of weapons they have on offense, they're going to be tough to beat today.
Well, one of those weapons has been slowed. Russell White, what's his status?
He's got an upper respiratory infection, and that's the least of what we've heard so far. The big question, since he's had this for 3 weeks and hasn't been able to recover, and he hasn't practiced all week, is he ready and fit for this ball game? His legs may be fresh, but we just don't know how strong he's going to be.
Oregon comes in here 3-2. They have dubious opportunity of playing the two unbeaten Pac-10 teams. In 2 weeks, they go against Washington. They have a first-rate defense, and a third down conversions, they're allowing only 26% success rate.
Well, they put other teams in a bind on third down, then they're able to utilize what is best about their defensive unit, their secondary. Their people in the secondary can cover extraordinarily well. They've got a big guy in the middle, Marcus Woods, who is just solid and strong, and he takes care of the short stuff. But they're going to be up against it because Cal is so balanced.
Well, and Oregon has a new quarterback. Brett Salisbury will get his first start, but they're excited about him.
He is very excited. Yesterday, he celebrated his 23rd birthday. He is a drop-back passer, which is good for this offensive system. But the big question is, with Cal's aggressive defense, they love to blitz, and we saw it last week against UCLA. Can he read it? Can he get the ball off? Will he succumb to the pressure?
Oregon hasn't won here in Berkeley since 1960. This is their 57th meeting. As you can see there, the underdog hasn't won 7 of the last 9 games. Oregon won the toss. They have deferred. Tommy Thompson, who will kick without a shoe but will punt with one, will kick off. Wolf Barber and Tyrone Edwards back deep. It'll be Barber who will bring it out for the Golden Bears. He'll bring it out across the 15 to the 18-yard line. And this high-powered offense of California will start from there. There's the guy that's directed it, Mike Pulaski. You can see thus far he's thrown 10 touchdown passes. He's sixth in the country in pass efficiency. He'll have Chapman starting. We'll see Russell White before the game gets too old. Tricks, the all-time leading receiver at Cal, catch-wise. Dawkins, he is a threat on the outside as well. He'll play the slot back at times as well as the tight end. That's the reason for the listing of both of those in our starting picture. Line of scrimmage, the 19-yard line. The Golden Bears with a 4-0 record. Pulaski back. Dumps it far side. It's complete to Holly, the fullback. He's got a first down. There's the line. Ozine, he'll be playing on Sundays. Zagapolo, the biggest offensive lineman they've ever had. Malum has been playing some center this week. They're very thin in that offensive line, but they are very confident with this offensive line, as is this guy. They are tough. This is a mentally tough football team. Pulaski giving off to Chapman, and Chapman skips up to the 40-yard line. Brooks' teams have always been good defensively. Up front, they've made some changes as Matt Labonte is out after arthroscopic surgery. Gary Williams replaces him. This is not a big linebacking core, but very active. Farwell did not play last week. He's had all kinds of problems with an ankle. Watch Coda and Castle at the safety positions. They are headhunters. They will hit you. Hand off to Chapman again, running wide, and he goes nowhere. Big stick by that safety I was just talking about, Eric Castle. And we watch films of him, Lynn, and he will take your head off.
He certainly will. He comes up strong. He's not afraid to take you on. He reads extremely well, so he can get into the mix very quickly from a safety position.
Third and long is 3rd and 9 as they come out this time with 3 wideouts. The split backs, Pulaski to throw. Scrambling out of the pocket, and he's going to be tackled for no gain. Terrell Edwards, Brian Brown will go back for the Ducks. Just underway, no score. Left-footed punter. Brown not calling for the fair catch, and he's going to be downed inside the 30-yard line. Brett Salisbury, his first start for the Oregon Ducks. He came in relief of Danny Oneil last week when Oneil went out for the year with an injured right hand. His brother Sean played at USC, now with the Minnesota Vikings. After a clipping penalty, they inherit the football at the 15-yard line. Anthony Jones will come in motion. Salisbury to throw on first down. Pressure up the middle. Throws near side. Jones, he makes the catch at the 19-yard line. Burwell is one of the most underrated backs in the Pac-10. Shedrick, a tough fullback. You just saw Jones make the catch a moment ago. Thomason, they want to involve him more, tight end. Up front, this is they consider their best offensive line in years. They've had to move people around, and Howington at 310 pounds is a freshman. Jones in motion to the top of the field. Salisbury gives to Burwell. He gets a couple to the 21-yard line. Defensively, this Cal defense, which gets better as the game wears on, especially in the fourth quarter. Mac Travis is outstanding at the nose guard. He had a big sack last week against UCLA. Barsala is starting. He's been hurt most of the year. He's a junior college standout. And in that secondary, Cannon has thus far two interceptions. Zummel is the younger brother of Greg, and he'll hit you. Jones in motion to the near side. Salisbury sprinting this way. He's got the completion of Burwell. He's got the first down. Also, it gives Salisbury some confidence. Early going, his first start, and he's connected on a couple of passes. Now out to the 30-yard line. Salisbury to Burwell. Nothing on this play. Loss of one. Second and 11 now from the 29-yard line. From the shotgun is Salisbury. Deep drop. Hook out. Backside. It's loose. Ahanatu has picked it up, but they're going to roll it back dead. The ball will be dead at the 14-yard line.
Now, this is what I mean about the pressure, Gary. They didn't blitz everyone. They rushed four people. But just from the outside, a four-man rush, they get great pressure. They get the sack. They get the fumble, the turnover. Now they're inside the 20-yard line going for a touchdown. They didn't blitz. But the problem is, if you're looking for the blitz, you might make a mistake on your blocking assignment, and you see people there in the front, two blocking one man, and he just beats his around the outside.
They mark the ball at the 16-yard line. Pulowski mishandled, snap, he's got
it. Gary, I will tell you right off the bat, what I'm seeing right now in Cal's team is that they're not very high emotionally. They seem flat in this ball game. Last week when they played UCLA, they had about 10 mistakes, including the turnovers, that this team would like to eliminate. And you can't eliminate that number of mistakes automatically.
Second down now, 11 yards to go. Pulaski play action fakes, got time. Throws near side, complete. The catch is made at the 2-yard line. That is Mike Caldwell, the slot.
They refer to Caldwell as Mr. Clutch, because he just makes all the catches tough and hard, and he does it in the routine.
They love to go to him in clutch situations. First and goal now, outside the two. Pulaski to Chapman, and no place to go. The swarming Ducks are there. Excellent play by Marcus Woods, and you're going to hear a lot about him today. He's out of Corvallis. He is considered by Spike Dykes, who's the Texas Tech coach, who they played earlier this year, as the best in the country. He thinks he'll be a first-round pick. Whether he'll be a first-round pick or not, he is a solid player.
Man in the headset right there is Denny Shuler. He is the defensive coordinator.
And, of course, this is such an intertwined game between Snyder and Brooks. They have so many friends. They've played on the same teams. They've coached on the same teams. It's like a big family, but a family feud today. Second and goal from the five. Here's Chapman again, and Chapman back to the original line of scrimmage. And an amazing stat by Oregon, and look what Cal has done. Here's a third and goal. Pulaski on a rollout. End zone, touchdown, Brent Woodall, the tight end.
Take a look right here. Watch how it all develops. Woodall's 31. He just sneaks out. Now, this is Smith. He's got great coverage. But watch him as he's just going to fall down right here. Right there, he falls down, and the play opens up. But Oregon had a defense perfectly until Smith fell down.
Point after attempt now by Doug Ryan. It's 7-0. On a third and goal from the two, Pulaski stretching the defense, rolling out on this play, and Woodall with his first touchdown catch of the year.
He has a pattern going shallow. He just stays with it. Gets a fortunate break when number 20, Darryl Smith, falls down. Pulaski had some pressure. When he saw the man open, he put the ball on the money for the touchdown.
The offense keeps putting him in a hole. Donovan Moore has trouble with this one. And he's going to be buried at the 10. Donovan Moore, a transfer from the University of Dubuque in Iowa. That time had a tough time, gets a ball just across the 10 before Wolf Barber was down there. Salisbury last week came in against New Mexico State when Oneil went down with a hand injury. Played pretty well. He threw a touchdown pass. He was the player that everyone had wanted out of junior college last year, as he threw for 3,300 yards and unbelievably 33 touchdowns. Palomar Junior College. First down across the 10. Anthony Jones in motion. Flag on the play. Salisbury throws that ball very awkwardly as he tried to pivot and throw to the near side to Vince Perry, the tight end.
Well, Cal doesn't have an apparent weakness. They're vastly improved on the defensive side of the ball. Their kicking game is very, very solid, and their offense is, I think, very explosive. They have the pass and the run and a lot of different ways to attack you with different weapons.
Oregon now, after that penalty, a first and five. Burwell, no place to go. Salisbury sprinting out, throwing far side, and the catch is made at the 19 by Anthony Jones. You can see Cal's had a tough time stopping teams on third down, giving up half of them successfully. Here's a third and one. Salisbury in a lot of heat. It's picked off by Wolf Barber. He's got it the 20. He has clear sailing to the goal line. Touchdown, California.
They're looking for pressure. It's a half roll. He's going to throw in between the seam, but as you said, when you talked about sailing, this ball sailed, Gary, right over the receiver's outstretched arms into Wolf Barber's
hand. Having back-to-back interceptions, one against UCLA's Tommy Maddox, this one for the touchdown. The point after makes it 14 to nothing. Ryan will kick this one to Donovan Moore. He feels this one much more successfully. Brings it up to 20. He's got a big block across the 25. And they're out to the 30-yard line. Monday night, the Giants and Steelers. Salisbury giving off now to Burwell. This is the best field position that Oregon's had.
That they can just block, put out there. Not for big gains, but 5 or 6 yards here and there.
There's going to be a first down run. Juan Shedrick, the big fullback. First down at the 49. Little mix up there. Burwell and Salisbury collide. The ball comes loose. But I think it's going to be ruled down. It is. Turnover to score the first. The second, an interception to score the second. And they're on top. The 13th ranked Golden Bears leading Oregon. It's this pass intended for Anthony Jones on the near side. There it is, Strawberry Canyon. Boy, this is something here. There's a lot of settings in college football, but doesn't get much better than this. Third down, 10 yards to go. Salisbury rifles one, far side, diving catch. Nope, they're going to rule it hit.
We'll take another look at it. You can see that Salisbury has a solid arm, steps right into it. That's a long pass to throw on the sideline. We'll take a look and see. Hands are there. Oh, yep. It just came out of his hand, took a little bounce, and he trapped it.
As Tommy Thompson, a sophomore, will punt the football. See, this time he has a shoe on as opposed to when he kicks off. And Brian Triggs will go back for Cal. Bounced it to him, but they didn't have a rush on. As an end result, he gets it away successfully, very successfully, as the ball is going to be down inside the 10-yard line.
Well, if this is World Series play, he'd be a great shortstop. Uses his body to block the ball, grabs it. As you said, no rush. He gets
Willie
it away.
Tate is the snapper. And we'll talk more about that later. That's going to be an adventure all day long. Handoff now to Russell White, who's into the game for the first time. And White for a couple of yards. Second and seven. Belosky rifles one. Sean Dawkins on the receiving end has a first down catch at the 33. Muhammad Oliver over to make the stop, an 11-yard gain. The reason he's the top-rated passer in the Pac-10. Here's a handoff to White, diving forward. Moves it out to the 38-yard line. Second down, 6 yards to go. Handoff this time to White, and a lot of congestion. As Marcus Woods, who Cal has a lot of respect for, jammed that one up over the middle. Such balance between the run and pass. Pulaski again. Dawkins makes a great catch at the 50. He's got open field at the 40. A flag on the play as he's being dragged down by Eric Castle.
Well, I'm concerned a little bit. He's healthy. He's gotten a clearance. Has not. What I'm concerned about is not practice. Because of the illness and the fatigue that's built up over the last couple of weeks. So his timing and his endurance, I think, will be the issue today. I think we'll find a guy with pretty lively legs on a carry or two. It's that 24-25 carries that I think might be an issue for him.
Don't hear a lot about him because of Triggs, but he is a quality receiver. Pulaski back. He's in trouble and hit that time by Terrell Edwards, the sophomore.
Andy Connor, number 47, was a man who came in. He put some pressure on him.
And you know, when you got a screen play or you're looking downfield, that first guy gets in there, quarterback starts to cock that ball, you jump up there, you got to stay with him, force him, then when he tried to run, the tackle was made.
And Noonan now punts away to Brown. Ryan Brown at the 30. And up to the 35, and Oregon now will have good field position at the 39.
He had an extremely low white count. He was found to have a low hemoglobin, which was a secondary anemia that he's had. And he had a chest infection with some mild x-ray evidence of a pneumonitis, or an inflammation of his left lung.
So how does that affect him today?
Well, fortunately, he's now in the third week of this illness and has been treated, and he has had a good response to treatment. He is not 100%, but he's been cleared to play. He's been seen by a pulmonary specialist. He's had good pulmonary function studies. It's just as to whether or not the environment and the heat and the exertion will cause him to be short of breath.
Well, this Oregon offense may be short of breath right now. Salisbury stormed down, got rid of the ball as Mick Barsala was down there to hurry that play up, and it brings up a 3rd and 9 now for the Oregon Ducks. Salisbury shaky early going on a 3rd down now. 3rd and 9, a flag on the play. Dumps it over the middle. Burwell. Burwell to the 50, and he's got enough for the 1st down. But let's see what the penalty's all about. Offside Cal, so that'll stand. And Oregon now, for the first time in this game, is in the California end of the field.
Attitude is so very important. We talked last week to Bruce Snyder about the changing attitude of this Cal team, gaining confidence. If this Oregon team can gain some confidence in this drive, you're right, they will be right in it.
Here's Burwell, tough going. He may have gotten a yard. They are storming down Burwell out of Canoga Park, California. A guy who, in the estimation of Rich Brooks, is the most underrated back in the Pac-10.
I do like their strategy, Gary, of trying to spread their offense to try and negate what the defense of Cal is doing. But that brings up one of the big questions in this ballgame. Can the receivers for Oregon beat the secondary people one-on-one to make the big play?
37 seconds left in the quarter. There's a real jumbled play ticking away here as we come to the end of this first quarter. It's been all Cal. The 13th-ranked Golden Bears trying to win their 5th game without a setback. It'll be their best start in 30 years. Well, they are in the cheap seats. They call that place Tightwad Hill. No one wants to pay the admission to come into this game today. And a beautiful setting over Memorial Stadium. Capacity here could be 77,000. And they're talking about a sellout next week for that Washington game. Start of the 2nd quarter. 3rd down now. 16 yards to go for Oregon. Trailing 14-0. Burwell, the single running back. 4 wideouts on this play. Salisbury to Harrison as he hit.
The 2 big turnovers by Oregon resulted in touchdowns by Cal. And other than that, there's not much offense we've been looking at this afternoon so far.
Thompson, big rush. Almost got that one blocked. Triggs is coming up. No fair catch at the 15, and good coverage by Oregon. Chad Cota was the first to get down there. Herman O'Berry was also there. Well, let's catch you up. After the fumble recovery, Whittle with his first touchdown catch of the year from 2 yards out from Pulaski. And then Wolf Barber picked off a pass, raced in 33 yards away, and at the 7:06 mark of the 1st quarter, 14-0. This is Chapman with the ball, and Chapman out to the 20, 21-yard line. Joe Farwell over to make the stop. We have a man shaken up for Oregon. It's Marcus Woods, and that is an injury that Oregon can ill afford right now, as Woods is by far the leader of that defensive forward wall. They've already lost Matt LeBounty along with Jeff Cummings. Here is Woods. He hasn't been playing great this year, but good. And one of the reasons is he's had ankle and arm problems. They expect great things from this guy. And Woods, out of Corvallis, got away from Oregon State to come to play for Rich Brooks and the Ducks of Oregon. So he's down right now. It looks like the left. Good to see him up and walking off. Rich Brooks has to be breathing a sigh of relief there. In fact, he's now running in place. So I think we're going to see number 69 again. Malapai, Salili Malapai from Honolulu, Hawaii, has come in now, replacing him at nose guard. Trigg split to the top of the field. Sean Dawkins to the near side. Pitch to Chapman. Chapman, 25. Chapman lowers his head, and he's got a first down out to the 28-yard line. Gain of 6. Harry Castle made the stop.
Let White sit out, utilize other people in this ballgame.
Here's Chapman the other side, across the 30, showing his quickness, lowers his head, and he's got another first down. The ball comes loose, but it's blown dead. That's a 12-yard run. First down for the 40-yard line. Blitz coming up the middle. Pulaski gets rid of it. Dawkins is down here. He makes the catch. Dawkins against Muhammad Oliver.
Well, Pulaski hangs tough. It's good play action. Buys himself a little bit more time to watch the hit he takes. He releases, opens himself up, and takes a shot. But the ball is skyward, and when it comes down, there is all of 6 foot 4 inch Dawkins there to make the catch. That is a catch made purely because of a height differential.
He had 6 catches for 62 yards last week. He already has 4 touchdown grabs, 41-yard catch. And here's Russell White back into the ballgame. White will negotiate the 15-yard line. Eric Castle over there to make the stop. 8-4. Second down, 6 now for the 15-yard line. Here is White. White makes a nice move. He's going to duck it inside the 10 to the 5. Lunges to the 1. And that's the Russell White that is just so extraordinary.
Well, you see much more of his strength, Gary, in this run because he takes it to the outside. He's not quite as smooth when he makes his cut. Good move to get inside. But now watch. He just decides to come inside. Then he lowers his head. Good balance there. As he almost breaks it into the end zone.
First and goal at the 1. White diving. Did he get in?
No.
No indication of that. It'll be second and goal. He got spun around on that play. Tremendous hit by the interior of that Oregon defense.
White
still in the backfield with some all ahead of him. White this time diving in. He lunges across, and California has taken a 20-0 lead.
Although White did not practice all week long, his legs got a chance to rest. He comes in this ball game fresh. The coaches are putting him in the ball game, making sure he doesn't lose that game readiness, I believe.
Here is Brian making it a 21-0 lead. Brian to kick off. It's going to be short. It'll be Donovan Moore for the third time, and he bobbles this one. Second time he's done that, and Moore brings it out to the 18. Boys have a tough time. As an end result, Oregon will not have good field position again. They have a procedure call now against Cal, so now Oregon will come out of there with better field position. 5-yard penalty moves the ball back to the 30, and Brian will kick off now. Line drive, and this will go out of bounds, so they'll get it at the 35-yard line.
That's an interesting development.
Well, they have the option. They can
Would you take a penalty instead of taking it to the 35-yard line?
Well, I don't know, Gary. Maybe he figures he can get the ball in better field position than the 35.
No legal procedure. Kicking the ball out of bounds. Against the kicking team. New rule. The offense will take the ball at the 40-yard line.
Salisbury, the quarterback, his first start, and it's been a shaky start thus far. Play action. He's in trouble. Mac Travis has got him. 17 to go in the first half. California, 13th ranked with a 21-0 lead. Salisbury, near side, complete to Burwell. In the open field, he's across the 40. He's to the 50, 45 to the 41-yard line. And there is some of that elusiveness, explosiveness of Burwell. That'll be a 29-yard gain, and that might be a beginning point for this Oregon team.
You see all the guys bunched up in the middle. They're coming after him a little bit. A little play action. The ball comes out to the screen. All the Cal defenders are on the inside. He picks up a good block on the outside here. A little tug on the jersey. That helps. Eric Zumwalt, 23. David Wilson, 25, come in for the stop.
So the 29-yard gain moves it to the 40. Salisbury, quick fake up the middle. The pass is intercepted, and then we have a flag. Let's listen.
The eligible receiver on the offense downfield. Penalty refused. California ball.
So the interception will stand. Let's look at it again.
At the bottom of the screen, there's the ball going. He's looking for a receiver. And that's 75. Collinsworth blocking. And the ball's picked off, and he reaches and grabs. But they're saying he's downfield. That was a penalty.
He was picked as the Pac-10 newcomer of the year defensively. He's a junior college transfer. He was headed to Ohio State, found out the transfer rule. He'd only have 1 year of eligibility, so then elected to come to the California Bears. And here is Chapman across the 40 to the 41-yard line.
He was out, so they didn't feel like he had the practice time, so they weren't having him play quite as much.
But they started him today after not starting him last week. Three turnovers in the game by this Oregon team. Here is Chapman straight up the middle, and he'll take it across the 50. Bounces down to about the 49-yard line of Oregon. Eric Castle made the stop, an 11-yard gain. What a luxury to have. When you don't have White, you got Chapman. Last year, it was White and Anthony Wallace. So, I'll tell you, Bruce Snyder has really developed this program. Not only do they have some frontliners that can play, they've got some depth.
And when White's injured, as he is now, not playing as much, perfect opportunity for him to come in, keep the team moving.
Here's Pulaski faking the pitch in a little bit of trouble, and he's just going to throw it to the far side, and Triggs, a juggling catch.
He gets on the sideline. You think the ball is going to be picked off. Pulaski under pressure, buys time. Now watch this play. The ball is hit by the defensive back, goes off Triggs' chest in the air, and he stays with it for the catch.
142nd of his career, which is a Cal record. Pulaski is 7 of 7 now, 120 yards. He's putting on a clinic. He's rolling to the near side, buying some time. Up the field, and that'll be his first incomplete pass. For Triggs, Castle defending on the play along with Darryl Smith.
Every time Triggs catches a pass, he extends that reception record by Wesley Walker. He needs about 60, 65 yards a game here for about the next three games, and then they hope he can break the record in front of a crowd for homecoming when they're going to honor Wesley Walker.
Against this school called, what, USC?
Yeah, I guess.
You've heard of them, haven't you? Here's Russell White, fumbles the ball, and I think Cal has recovered.
It's amazing what longer hair, a beard, and a mustache can do the clean-cut look of Stables, huh?
I noticed that. Steve Gordon was the guy that recovered that fumble, and now Cal moving to the 20-yard line. Relentlessly, they're moving this football. Pulaski has him down. A fourth down and a yard to go.
Looks like he's checking out of it.
And Pulaski hands off to White, and the flags will stop this.
He played the Bruins last
year. Dead ball foul. False start on the offense. Oh. 5-yard penalty. Still fourth down.
It'll be a 42-yard attempt by Doug Bryan. Now we have a stoppage again. Snap a little high. Bryan's kick is underway. A lot of distance and right down the pipe. Well, we talked about the success of Doug Bryan. 3 weeks ago in Tucson, he boots this field goal to pick up the win over the Arizona Wildcats. And then if you were with us last week, the site was the Rose Bowl. And from 47 yards out, this would be a career long for him and ends up being the difference as they go into UCLA and win for the first time in Los Angeles in 9 years. And just a moment ago, he added a 42-yarder in this one, and he just kicked this one almost down to the ballpark.
Build on one success. What they have to do, again, come back with the screens. Good plays against either the blitz or zone coverage or the short rush.
It's kind of a delayed handoff to Burwell, and Burwell does a nice job getting outside, brings it out to the 26-yard line. Oregon started out with a couple of wins. Then they lost to Utah, to USC, came back to win last week. Here's a handoff to Shedrick, the fullback, and he runs into a lot of blue jerseys there. One wide receiver, Jones, will go in motion. Handoff, Burwell, and that's Travis again. Oh, is he something?
In other words, he comes off that line of scrimmage so strong and so fast. Hard to block him, hard to stop him. Right there, he just took on the blocker.
Big rush, almost blocked that time. We may have a roughing the kicker. Ball bouncing around. Oregon will down it at the 41. They're picking the flag up now. They're picking it up. Look at this. He got a piece of the ball first. Let's look at it. The flag has been picked up. He got a piece of the ball so he can make the contact.
Very good.
Ends up being a 31-yard punt. The Oregon coaching staff and this California coaching staff. Head coach Bruce Snyder, some of his assistants, played at Oregon, coached at Oregon. In fact, I guess both Snyder and Brooks were pretty good football players. Defensive backs in their days. 6.5 minutes left, first half. And firing off is Woodall, the tight end.
I guess you could say that coaching family up from Oregon is extended a little bit. Snyder was also with John Robinson, who was the head coach of the Rams, who was also an assistant at Oregon. And while he was there, Jerry Fry was a head coach, and George Seifert, who is now the head coach of the San Francisco 49ers, were all a part of that same staff. Matter of fact, Jerry Fry, who's now one of the scouts for the Denver Broncos, is here today watching the team play, checking them out with his son who writes, one of his sons who writes for the Oregon.
Atlanta still with a 6-2 lead now in the fourth inning. We'll keep you posted on that. That series even at one. And here's a handoff to Chapman, and he's in the open field. He's to the 50. Castle has some help with Cota alongside him to knock him out of bounds.
When you're working very well, let's look at some things that you don't do so well. You can stand to be picked on a little bit, okay? All right, here's Chapman. He gets the ball. Big hole. Lines great. But what he doesn't do is open his eyes. When you talk about the vision of a running back, being able to see where to run to, he didn't show us that in that last play. That could have been a touchdown.
He was 10 of 55 before that carry, and add on another 15 as he takes it inside the 30-yard line.
At the 28-yard line now, Cal with another first down. Right now, Cal is just sensational. Here's Russell White, tripped up in the backfield that time. Coming up was Cota, the redshirt freshman out of Ashland, Oregon, who they're so high on. There he is. He will come after you. As they say, he will splatter people. He was the state's defensive player of the year his senior year. Had his first start last week and had an interception. Toma Piao. Hand off White. Nice change of direction. And White to the 21-yard line. Wow. The balance of this Cal team is amazing. They're rushing for 252 a game and passing for 256. That is balance. Pulaski back, got time over the middle, crossing pattern, Sean Dawkins, 15, 10, 5, California touchdown.
He gets a lot of the pressure, but in this coverage, he takes the heat, but Sean Dawkins is coming across in the zone, crossing pattern against the zone coverage. Pulaski reads it, and he just runs into the end zone through the seams.
Everybody talks about Treggs, but Dawkins is an outstanding receiver. He has four catches for 89 yards as Bryan makes it a 31-0 ball game. One of the landmarks here at the University of California, the Campanile to the left as you look across this beautiful campus. And right now, the Cal fans are enjoying themselves, as is this guy, Dawkins, getting a very big workout in this first half. He's going to kick this one out of bounds as well. Cal in this quarter has 9 first downs. Oregon won. 31-0 the score. Salisbury's got time. Waits for the receiver to clear, and it's intercepted by David Wilson.
Salisbury just tries to put a lot of velocity. A little half roll to get away from pressure on the backside. It's a crossing pattern. He just throws it in there behind the receiver. And David Wilson does a great job of being able to get his hands on this one and hang on to it.
What an indoctrination he's had in his first start. 4:38 now left in the first half. Pulaski will start this drive just short of the 40 and a flag.
So delay a game.
Dead ball foul. Delay of the game. Against the offensive team, 5-yard penalty, first down.
This is the kind of win a team that's trying to become one of the best in the nation has to have.
First and 15 now. Handoff this time goes to Tyrone Edwards. He's a true freshman. He made his debut last week carrying the ball a couple of times. Cal putting some alternate people in the lineup right now. Pulaski, quick drop, complete to Simeon, who just came in. He's to the 35, and he'll be about 3 yards short of the first down. Herman O'Berry made the stop there. Pulaski spreading it around, and now we have a late flag at the 35-yard line where Simeon was tackled.
The offensive team, 15 yards. It'll be third down.
Personal foul. I don't know where it is. Can you see it here?
There's the catch. That's against Cal. And he gets up.
Well, is that it there? Well, that moves it all the way back to the 50-yard line now. Third and 19, and here comes Marty Holly, Buddy Holly, known by his teammates. Flag on the play. Brown calling for the fair catch. He'll let it hit, and it's going to make it in for the touchback, but a penalty flag at the line.
I feel like his team played emotionally very well last week at home against New Mexico State. He was concerned about that, and he's going to make a change at quarterback. They're going to refuse the penalty. Kyle Crowston out of Vancouver, Washington, who has played some defensive back this year for Oregon, will come in as a new quarterback. So he's going to get Salisbury out of there, and here is Crowston. He's more of a spread-out, option-type quarterback. He was an option quarterback in high school. Very, very mobile. So they're going to try something different here from the 20. Pitch to Burwell. Wolf Barber made some nice penetration, but Burwell got around him and gets it to the 25 before David Wilson knocked him out of bounds. So Salisbury leaves the game, and it's kind of half that he'd just as soon forget about. As you can see, Crowston coming into this ball game had attempted two passes. Salisbury was 6 of 12, 57 yards and 3 interceptions. Second and 5 for the Ducks. 3:10 left in the first half. Burwell, big hole. And Burwell out to the 31. That'll be a first down.
The 31-yard line.
First down now. 2:50 left in this one in the first half. Crowston over the middle. Broken up. Thomason was the intended receiver. He had cleared over the middle, but the ball never got there. Jones will go in motion. Crowston with the play action. He's got a lot of people in his face. Screen pass complete to Burwell, and Cal seemingly playing with 15 men on the field. They had everybody deployed perfect. 31-0. 13th ranked Cal, and now all kinds of movement. Perry moved, got back, and let's see what
dead happened. Ball foul, offside on the defense. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
Third down and 2 now after the penalty with 1:57 left in the first half. Anthony Jones in motion. Crowston sprinting that way. Throwing far side. Jones and Wolf Barber heading covered all the way. Thompson, who's been busy, will punt once again. Bruce Callen is back this time. He's going to return the punt. They've been having tricks most of the time, and Callen does a nice job. Well, how good is this California football team? You know, a lot of people will wonder after this one as a carry now by Tyrone Edwards. We asked that very question of Bruce Snyder.
Oh, in fact, I'm not real sure that we're physically as gifted as last year's team. I'm really not. Or do I believe necessarily that we're as good as 13th in the country, talent-wise. But we have the heart of a 13th-ranked team. I don't think there's any question about the toughness and the attitude, which I'm probably more proud of that than maybe anything else.
Boy, they have played with heart today, haven't they?
No, they certainly have, and heart and pride and attitude will get you to a higher ranking faster than talent.
Hand off to Edwards, and the true freshman with a little burst to the outside takes it to the 44. 9 seconds, we're going to have a timeout call.
At the University of Oregon, we believe that great teachers make great students is more than a lesson of history. It's also a lesson of science, a lesson of art, a lesson of biology, a lesson of psychology, a lesson of anthropology, a lesson of language, a lesson of life.
Well, Rich Brooks, his team called that timeout with 9 seconds left. I think they just want to end this half, get into the locker room, regroup. Woodall, the short man. Good snap from Ben. Kicks it off the side of his foot, however, and the ball angling out of bounds with 2 seconds left now, so Oregon will have one snap. Movement up front, a flag. Croson, quarterback draw, comes up across the 25, and he'll be far enough up the field for a first down.
Offside on the defense. 5-yard penalty. The half will be extended.
It pays when you play against a defense that puts that kind of pressure on you, as the Cal defense does, to have a quarterback that's mobile enough that can get himself out of trouble.
But they had that in Danny O'Neill. Now, he's not as mobile as Crowston, but he was more mobile than Salisbury, who's a pure pocket passer. Now they got three guys put to the near side, a little trips formation, that little Mississippi Valley State type play. Croston looking to this direction, and he's going to be dropped, and that will bring to a close a long first half if you're the Oregon Ducks.
East Carolina at the Carrier Dome beat Syracuse 23-20. Jeff Blake, a 43-yard touchdown run. He had 324 yards passing and a TD. What a great win for Bill Lewis and his squad. And as you look at the Pirates' schedule, they've beaten Memphis State, who beat Southern Cal, Central Florida, South Carolina, Goodwin, Akron, and now Syracuse. East Carolina, that's a team you're going to be talking about for the rest of the year after that upset.
The Pacific 10 Conference has long been known as the Conference of Champions. Pac-10 success in football and men's basketball is unparalleled nationally. Yet the Pac-10 may be best known for supporting the nation's strongest overall athletic program, having captured the most NCAA championships in both men's and women's sports. The Pac-10 region stretches throughout the glorious West, from Arizona to California and north to Oregon and Washington. For 76 years, the Pacific 10 Conference has held to its commitment to being the Conference of Champions.
Good afternoon. I'm Carol Simpson in Washington. The unprecedented Senate hearings on the nomination of Judge Clarence Thomas to the Supreme Court continue, and Judge Thomas is still in the witness chair, denying charges that he sexually harassed former aide Professor Anita Hill. After more than 6 hours of emotional questions and answers, tempers are wearing thin. Just a short while ago, Republican Senator Orrin Hatch and Chairman Joseph Biden, a Democrat, exchanged sharp words over whether Hatch should be allowed to quote an FBI report on the allegations against Thomas.
Someone on this committee releases her statement and materials from the FBI report for all the world to see, and the newspapers to print, and the media to show, that are tremendously damaging to the judge because they've been brought up in open forum, that had to occur because somebody in a sleazy way broke the rules.
Senator.
No, wait, let me just finish.
I'm going to let you finish, and then I'm going to cut you off real quick.
Well, if you think you're going to cut me off, I think you're wrong.
And Judge Thomas passionately said he believed someone or some interest group is out to destroy him.
I believe that in combination, this story was developed or concocted to destroy me.
With Professor Hill. And it's a critical question. Are you saying with Professor Hill that a group...
That's just my view, Senator.
I know, I'm trying to make sure you understand.
There's no details to it or anything else. The story developed. I do not believe the story is not true. The allegations are false, and my view is that others put it together and developed this. I'd rather die than withdraw. If they're going to kill me, they're going to kill me.
I'm Carol Simpson in Washington. We'll keep you up to date as events warrant. The second half of the game coming up in a moment.
On Tuesday, the Pasadena Tournament of Roses president, Robert L. Cheney, made an announcement. Here it is.
Please join me in welcoming the Grand Marshal for the 1992 Tournament of Roses, the 20th direct descendant of Christopher Columbus, whose picture you see here, His Grace Cristobal Colon, or for those of you who would like it in English, Christopher Columbus.
Cristobal Colon, the 20th descendant by direct line of Christopher Columbus, will serve as Grand Marshal for the 103rd Tournament of Roses Parade, all of which you'll see right here on ABC. And we're ready to go in the second half. Ryan kicking off for the Bears.
I was going to say that little point was the Transamerica Pyramid Building.
Muhammad Oliver will bring it out for the Ducks. Up to the 15, and that's it. Crowston will start the second half. After Salisbury tried and had a long afternoon in the first half, going 6 of 12 for 57 yards and 3 interceptions. California defensively, you see they've distributed the tackles pretty well. From the 15-yard line, Crowston, play action, being chased, gets rid of it. Jeff Thomason, the tight end, and he has a first down. Can't be a great neighborhood. Hand off to Burwell, and Burwell fumbles the ball, and California's got it, and that's the fifth turnover against Oregon.
Take another look. It's almost as if it's, when you start making mistakes, as if it's some kind of infectious disease. Unless you get it under control, it just continues to grow and build and affect everyone on the ball.
Who was the guy who came up with the fumble recovery? Sets it up outside the 25-yard line. Pulaski opens the second half at quarterback. Play action fake. Wide open. Far side Briggs. He makes a move at the five. They're going to really out of bounds.
He sure did. He had a great first half.
He had four catches for 89 yards. Handoff this time to Chapman, and Chapman not gaining anything on that play. And that'll give us a chance to look at some of those statistics. The big one, of course, the four turnovers.
You see him right there. Then you also look at total yards. 73 for Oregon, 271 for Cal. and they're adding a few more to it at this very moment. Time of possession, you would think that Cal would have had the ball a good deal more this time.
He is 10 of 11 now, 171 yards. He led the nation in passing efficiency prior to this week. He may take that lead again. Here is Chapman running. He takes it to the 5-yard line. They're down 6 yards to go. Triggs will come in motion to the near side. Pulaski rolling this way, flushed out of the pocket. He's in trouble, gets rid of it. Batista, James Batista, who had an interception last week for Oregon, number 45 out of Daly City.
But take a look at the pressure. Pulaski actually gets very good protection here, moves out of the pocket to buy a little more time, and that's when number 45 comes in and pressures him into the throw.
And on the offense, 15 yards from the spot of the foul. Third down.
Again, that's the only thing Cal's had trouble with is penalties. In the first half, they had 11 for 65 yards. Now 12 for a total of 83. Make those mistakes and hope to beat the third-ranked team, Washington. Pulaski back again. Flushed out. Backside pressure. Got rid of it. Boy, he was hit by Andy Connor.
He drops back. He's getting the pressure. It's coming from the outside. He moves. He knows he's running out of time. Feels that pressure and throws the football away.
Pulaski to hold. The kick on the way by Brian, and Brian missed this one. Berkeley, California, the home of the 13th-ranked California Golden Bears, are making a strong move today to try to move into the top 10 in the rankings next week as they will play host to the Huskies of Washington. What a battle that'll be. Pitch comes back to Burwell, and Marcella is there again. He has really played a strong game. There's the kind of pressure Cal's been putting on. Burwell's carried the ball 14 times and gotten only 21 yards. And that kind of afternoon, Crowston on a sprint out. Being chased, gets away from Wilburn, throws against the grain, and it's broken up nicely.
They roll, and he gets more time because he's rolling out, but he stops to throw back, and there's still a crowd of blue jerseys downfield. Look at all the jerseys. Ball's tipped right there.
Third down now, 12 yards to go. Crowston falls down, and that just kind of adds insult to injury, doesn't it? 11:22 left in the third. Nice rush put on. He hit it very high. Fair catch called for by Callen, and he makes it at the Bear 47-yard line. Well, you can't see a lot of it, but the Golden Gate Bridge in the background with the fog here in the San Francisco area. I've been here on days when it's so clear, and it is spectacular, to say the least. Looks like the Bears have one of those Oregon guys treed right now. Got him up the tree.
You might say he's out on the limb.
From the 47-yard line, California has the football with a 31-0 lead. 11:14 left in the third. Pulaski has Russell White in the backfield. He's looking to Russell. Here comes the pass up to the 45. Makes a nice move across the 50. Holly and White in the backfield. Here comes Russell. He tripped over somebody.
Well, Gary, you know, coming into this ball game, Oregon was a little bit concerned because last year when they played here, they did a lot of tripping up on this turf. You see the shoes. They brought down three pair of shoes. The closest ones to you are the AstroTurf shoes, and sometimes they work very well. But most of the guys are wearing the shoe in the middle, which is a basketball shoe. The third shoe is a rain shoe, which is not going to come into play here this afternoon.
Brooks wishes it was just a footwear problem today. It was the first down by Majorment. Here is White, far side, and White gang tackle. Pulaski. He's been brilliant. Second down and 9. Off to Marty Holly. Holly can't get much out of that. Gets back to the line of scrimmage. Scoreboard speak for him now, right?
Absolutely.
31-0. Pulaski on a 3rd and 9. Triggs makes the catch. He's going to be short of the first down. And now Pulaski dropping back, and they're going to have to have a timeout call. Oregon asks for the timeout. Stops the clock with 8:07 left here in the third quarter. Fourth down, and they come back out. Pulaski, and they snap it, and flags everywhere. A penalty against California. Bruce, you wanted to do something.
I missed the chance to have a little fun.
51-year-old Bruce Snyder, fifth year, the co-Pac-10 coach of the year. Last week, his record for his tenure here went over the 500 mark. He was 23-22-4 with a win over UCLA. Oh, he hit that one funny. Shanks it off the side of his foot. And let's see where they're going to mark this one. It'll come back out across the 15, and they're going to mark the ball at the 22-yard line. Well, you may not know this, but Bruce Snyder and Rich Brooks played against each other in college. Bruce Snyder's a defensive back for the Oregon Ducks. Brooks, the defensive back for Oregon State. His coach at that time was Tommy Prothro, who later went on to UCLA. Now, I can't understand this. Brooks is a defensive back, and he's throwing the football. I don't understand that picture.
He was dreaming. Picture day.
First down now from the 22 for the Ducks. Grosten is still a quarterback and all kinds of movement.
Dead ball. Illegal snap on the offensive team. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
It's only the second penalty against Oregon, but they have really been playing very well under Barry Alvarez. First and 15 now. Here's Burwell, bursts across the 25, and he lowers his head. He's about a yard short of the first down.
He had 189 yards against Washington State, which is still the best effort in the Pac-10 this season.
Second down a yard. Burwell goes in motion this time. Croston fumbles the ball, picks it up, and somehow gets it back and is tackled for a loss. All right. Croston back again. Over the middle, Burwell, he's got it. It's a foot race, and he's going to be tackled from behind by David Wilson.
Dropped him at the 42.
Well, certainly they have great speed. And if you take a look at Barsala, watch him, he's playing the ball. Burwell just goes right by him, passes in the air. He doesn't have a chance to make the play. Now we find out that David Wilson has just the same amount of speed. He plays what they call the Patriot position for the Bears. And right there, he looks like he's tracking him right all the way down the field.
Burwell has 5 catches for 80 yards today. Here he goes running the ball and scampers inside the 40-yard line. A gain of 4. It'll be 2nd and 6. Second down. Virtually 8 yards to go from the 40-yard line. Croston again. Blitz coming. He avoids the on-rushing guy, and then he's tackled by Monahan. Watch this blitz.
You see Barsala, number 13, coming through. Nice little move there. Croston keeping his wits about him.
Not to mention his head. For this Cal team, they can tee off, and you never know when they're coming. They're coming again. Croston reads it, gets it off to Harris, and Harris makes the catch and moves it inside the 35 to the 34, a couple of yards short of the first down.
That, my friends, is the fastest developing screen you will ever see in college football. He's got a blitz, and he's dropping back, and the screen is forming. They're all coming. It's a great play to call against the blitz, but unfortunately, you don't have much time to play at. And Croston had to leap into the air just to find his receiver, which he knew was coming across underneath that screen.
Well, he's a good athlete, Croston, and he had to be there. Harris making the catch. He's been shut down today. Fourth down and a yard, and what happened here?
Didn't get the exchange from center again.
They had the same.
Here problem. It is. The ball just drops right underneath him.
So that drive comes to a screeching halt as Pulowski comes out. Sean Dawkins makes a catch to the 45-yard line.
One really good receiver who often motivates that other guy to be better.
That's the first time Dawkins has been over 100 yards in a game. He now has 5 for 101 as White now. Maybe got back to the line of scrimmage. James Batista over there along with Terrell Esparr with 3 minutes and a few seconds plus left in the third quarter. Second down, 10, throw intended for Simeon, and broken up. That was Oliver, who was a Pac-10 decathlon champion. From the 45, third down, let's make it 11 yards to go. Pulaski, blitz, he gets rid of it, and he gets stormed. Down to receive the punt now from Noonan, big rush put on. Very high punt, and Brown calls for the fair catch. He had to wait a long time on that one. From the 7-yard line, the Ducks. 2:49 left in the third. Croston sprinting out. He's going to take off. He comes out to the 15 and is tackled there. Boy, this guy runs well. Out of Oklahoma or Texas A&M and Baylor. Be sure to check your local listings. Croston over the middle, intended for Thomason behind him.
Guy's back there waiting. And he throws it just a little bit. It's a little high. Receiver has to go up for it. Tips it. And you get nervous when the ball is tipped like that because the defensive back comes in there, and now he has a great play on the ball.
You get nervous when you get extended like that, too, waiting on the ball, right?
It's like your ribs are asking for company.
Third down and 2. Croston delivering far side. Jones makes the catch. There is a flag in the secondary.
Against the defense, 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. First down.
14th penalty against Cal for 97 yards. From the shotgun. Now with the first down by penalty, Crowston, and he'll be tackled for a loss. From the 25-yard line, second down 10 for the Oregon Ducks, trailing 31-0. Crowston, quarterback draw, but didn't fool anybody. Scoreless third quarter, but Cal's defense has been impressive. The first half, they jumped to that 31-0 lead, and now they're coming after this Oregon team. Crowston dumps it off, complete to Harris, to the 30. He's going to get a first down, to the 40. There's a flag on the play, 50. Harris, who's a sprinter on the track team for Oregon, is tackled by Wilson, and that's twice now. David Wilson has caught a man from behind. Here's the play once again that will come back.
Looking at the blitz all day long. This time it wasn't a blitz, but a lot of bodies there. They set up the screen. Ronnie Harris, number 81, gets to the outside. And Gary, doesn't he look like a sprinter right here? Kind of gets a sprinter's form. He's reaching forward, but right there, number 25, David Wilson, makes his second touchdown saving tackle.
Well, if you look very carefully, you can see the Oakland Bay Bridge in the background here with the fog and over into the San Francisco area. It's been a bright, clear day for the California Golden Bears, though, as we start the fourth quarter. And now we've got some pushing and shoving going on.
Just hold on.
Offsides on the defensive team. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
Oregon's deepest penetration was a Cal 40 on one occasion. Crowston back to throw as we start this fourth quarter. Flag on the play, he throws, bounces it to Thomas. Look at that, 19 yards rushing by Oregon.
And if you're an Oregon fan, don't even bother looking at this because it's not pretty at all.
And now to punt the football will be Thompson. We're just underway in the fourth quarter. Brett Callen goes back to receive the punt for the Golden Bears of Cal. High snap. Big rush. It's blocked. It's going into the end zone. Cal will get on it for the touchdown.
Well, they just kind of put their ears back and come after it. There you see the block right there. Number 14, Tim Manning. And as the ball gets into the end zone, it will spin like almost like a top. Just sets up very nicely. As you see, number 6, Jeff Jones out of Irvine High School coming in, covering it for the touchdown.
And so the point after by Bryant is good. It's 38-0. Donovan Moore returns this kickoff across the 25 and skips across the 30-yard line.
Expected them to lose, and it was a tight ball game.
Crowston delivering to Anthony Jones. Ball comes loose. Is it ruled a catch? No. Incomplete. From the 31, second down, 10 yards to go. We have 14 and a half minutes left in this game. Crowston double pumping. He's going to take off, and he's tackled. The ball comes loose, and California's got it. And a flag. A flag at the completion of the play. Roseman, Scott Roseman, the junior, coming up with a fumble recovery.
You watch him, he'll start to run, takes off, just hits from behind, and the ball stripped, comes loose, and they recover it. That's number 77, Steve Harden's going in. I think he just kind of mixed it up a little bit late.
And at the 18-yard line, Cal has it. Lasky gives off to Chapman, to the 10, 5, another touchdown.
And going in, that his raising of the hands was enough. That was good, that was fine.
I've never seen a quarterback do a backflip. That's a new one for me. Ryan, point after attempt. 14:30 left in this one. And he got it. Ryan kicking off. And at the 15, Donovan Moore will bring it up to the 25, to the 30. And Moore will fight his way close to the 40 and get across there. Third quarterback, Rich Brooks, will use today. Doug Musgrave, his brother Bill's here at the game. So Doug has a chance now to make a statement, and he throws the ball up and over the intended receiver, Brian Brown. Well, the worst setback in this series goes all the way back in October 22nd, 1921. Cal won that game 39-0. Now today, they would surpass that if this stays 45-0. So this series has been very tight. What did we say at the start of the broadcast? 7 of the last 9 outings, the underdog had won. Outing for Oregon, going back, was an 85, and they got beat by Nebraska 63-0. Musgrave back, throwing, and the catch is made by Donovan Moore.
Well,
Musgrave, he threads it that time. Nice throw to Thomas.
Jelinekic, look at coming in late in the ball game as kind of cleanup time, that sort of thing. But here's an opportunity for a guy who was coming in as your third team quarterback, your first team quarterback out for the season because of an injury. The job is really wide open at this point still. He can come in, show some talent and leadership ability.
Well, he certainly has good bloodlines, doesn't he?
Yes, he does.
His brother Bill, such a outstanding performer for Oregon. And Doug this time gets hit from behind, and Salisbury knows how that is. Starting quarterback, and they've used every one of them, other than Oneil, of course, who was hurt prior to this game, and falling down underneath center is Musgrave. And that didn't help their cause right there. A loss on the play. Third and 20. Musgrave buried again. The ball comes loose. There's a flag. We may have a face mask here.
We'll take a look at it. Grossman's number 43. Number 93 coming around the corner is Monahan. You see right there, Grossman just grabbing the face mask. Musgrave can make a statement here about trying to get a starting job if he can convert.
Hand off to Donovan Moore, and nice second effort, and Moore is close to the 40-yard line. Still 6-7 yards short of the first down. Michael Davis, who's from the Berkeley area, St. Mary's High School. Musgrave on target to Jones, and he threw it well, and that should be, if it isn't, awfully close to a first down. Look at this. Atlanta now leading the series 2-1. Boy, they are on fire down there in Atlanta, aren't they?
Oh, yeah.
Musgrave covering up there as Cal came roaring up there with Perry and Travis.
Dead ball, offside, on the defense, 5-yard penalty.
Boy, that's about the only thing I can find wrong with this team today. 45-0 they lead it. Lead it, I should say, with just over 10 minutes left. Here's Donovan Moore, bursts across the 20 to the 15, and that's another first down. First team secondary is in there right now for California. First down at the 15. Cal trying to get on the scoreboard. Here's Moore again. Another resourceful run. And the ball comes loose again, evidently. Cal is pointing the other way. No official confirmation from the official. Second down, 6. Anthony Jones goes in motion to flag on the play. Musgrave throwing far corner to Jones. Collision over there, and there's going to be a pass interference. Wolf Barber just ran over it.
Illegal formation on the offense. Pass interference on the defense. The penalty's offset. We'll replay the down.
But let's take a look at the shot that Anthony Jones takes. Now, he's going for the ball. Barber doesn't even look up. He just says, well, there's an open chest. Let me take a shot.
Woo. That almost ended up in Sacramento over there. Look at this.
Yeah, and there's the almost an interception there by Chris Cannon.
18 penalties for 127 yards. That's one shy of the school record. To throw Musgrave over the middle, and Perry, the intended receiver, Vince Perry, over the middle, couldn't get to the football.
Good pressure, excellent play call though. Perry's coming across, great opportunity there for the touch, for a catch and a touchdown. Ryan Perry, number 53.
I've seen you on the dance floor. I've seen something very similar to that out of you. Third down and 6. Musgrave back. Dumps it far side. The catch is made by Brandon Jumper. And Jumper, the fullback, to the 10, and that's it. And again, the pursuit, the quickness. And again, all the Cal starters in there. Musgrave's got to call timeout. Looked to me like Cal was as confused as anybody defensively. Doug Musgrave, the third quarterback today for Oregon, has done a very good job on this drive. He's trying to get it into the end zone. Anthony Jones comes in motion. Musgrave will roll to the near side. Got a block. Looking down the field, throws it up for grabs, incomplete.
Well, he had to throw it or get sacked. They did what they have been trying to do all afternoon, a little half roll, get a little more time. He's got a couple of receivers in the area, but the secondary reads it extremely well. They've got two people on the primary receiver. He gives his chance, he gives his receiver a chance to go up for the ball, but he just can't come up with it.
Perry Klein now will run the team at quarterback, gives off to Chapman, then he'll get a yard, maybe two. Gain of a yard, it'll be 2nd and 9 now. Hand up to Tyrone Edwards. Boy, you see why this freshman is going to be something in the future.
There's only one thing on the ready sheet he didn't find, a play called the copper pass.
There's Klein, quick out.
Before the game, he was looking for another ready sheet.
That's going to sit more lead stories. Never look for a ready sheet ahead of time. Here is Edwards again, and another burst, and almost another first down. Perry Klein out of Malibu, heavily recruited out of high school. Gives to Edwards again. Edwards getting a lot of valuable playing time. Or you'll see Illinois at Iowa, Colorado, Oklahoma, or Texas A&M, Baylor. Hand off to Edwards again. Edwards maybe a half yard or nothing at all, and it'll bring up second down. Tomapiao is down. John Tomapiao. He had arthroscopic surgery in the preseason on a knee, and they're looking at a knee right now. So we're going to take a break. 6:14 to go. Cal 45 to nothing. Tomapiao being helped up and off the field. Tomapiao reminds us of another guy we're showing the sideline. Look at this, how he gets his knee bent backwards underneath the tackle. Always dangerous. And, of course, we mentioned he had arthroscopic surgery on a knee. I want to show you somebody on the sidelines. Sagapolo. He's number 66. There he is. Now, this is a fire flow. 6 foot, 300, and, well, they say 35 pounds. I don't even think that's close. Look at him.
He's been a lot more than that in recent years, but he has been one of the top linemen for this Cal football team. And the interesting thing about him is that one of his favorite pastimes is shark spearing.
Well, he's from Auckland, New Zealand. Why not?
Yeah.
There's a lot of them over there.
He'd wade out into the water, and the shark would come in, and he'd spear him. I tell you, that's one tough guy.
Touchdown distribution. That's kind of interesting, isn't it? Two rush, two pass, one by defense, and one by special teams. Back to throw, Perry Klein, and that ball's almost intercepted. Cota had a shot at the interception after Darryl Smith stepped in front of the receiver. That's been the kind of afternoon it's been for the Oregon Ducks. Noonan gets it very high. Brown calling for the fair catch and makes it at the 30-yard line. And we'll go further in a moment. Musgrave in a quarterback. Complete to Brown. Brown across the 35. Nice move, and he has a first down out to the 45. Michael Davis made the stop. Musgrave, play action. Up the field, complete to Brown at the 40, and Brown has a first down catch at the 36-yard line, and this guy, number 17, may be starting next week at quarterback. Who knows? That's a 19-yard game. Brandon Jumper, the fullback, comes out of the ball game. Donovan Moore replaces him. 4:26 left in the game. Line of scrimmage, the 36 of California. Musgrave, double pumps, far side, complete. Donovan Moore make that. Kaelike Clifford, who made the catch. Number 42, a redshirt freshman out of Santa Ana. Oregon has a week off and probably comes at a good time. Then they have a game at Washington. They catch Stanford at home. Double pump by Musgrave, and the catch is made.
Anthony Jones, number 18.
I think that was Bob Brothers.
Bob Brothers, number 19?
Yep. Brothers was a quarterback a year ago. In fact, he had to play against Cal when Bill Musgrave was hurt. Came in a quarterback, now playing a wide receiver, also the holder on placements.
And this is no easy catch he makes here. He goes up. He's got a crowd of people around him. Darryl Brown, number one.
First and goal inside the 10-yard line. This is Clifford again. Kaelike Clifford, and he is close to the five and knocked down there. Second and goal now from the six. Musgrave to Donovan Moore, and he straightened up as he just got inside the five. It'll be third and goal there. Second time Musgrave has been down in this end of the field. Brothers in motion. Musgrave gets a block, throws, and it's caught by Clifford on a deflection for the touchdown. The ball was deflected by Ben Sperry, the tight end, and Clifford alertly comes up with it.
You have to believe, Gary, for a moment there, Ferry might have thought that Musgrave was going to run this ball in. Take a look. He's rolling out. His receivers are covered. Gets a good block to stop the backside pressure. You know, it looks like he might have just run that ball in. One receiver's calling for the ball. Ball's tipped, and it comes down to Clifford. That was Clifford. He was actually calling for the pass.
Give Ferry an assist. He had scored one touchdown rushing, his first receiving. Point after attempt by Greg McCallum is on the way, and good. Chevrolet most valuable players of the game. Eric Castle, the safety for Oregon, in on a lot of stops, and Mike Pulaski. Outstanding performance today from California. Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to assist those in financial need. Pulaski, 15 of 19, 198 yards, and two touchdowns. Kickoff fielded by Triggs. Dave Barr now, the third quarterback coming in out of Concord, California, redshirt freshman, number 16. Handing off, and we got a lot of new people in the ballgame now. Barr pitching to Fancher again, and Fancher goes nowhere.
Folks, you can write him and care of.
I grew up here in San Mateo, California, and I can't recall which is which.
Third down now, 8 yards to go. Fancher again, and 30-some seconds left in this one. Noonan hit it kind of funny. Brown, no fair catch, and he'll be tackled short of the 45-yard line.
Re-established football at Cal on the national level. They're contending for the Rose Bowl.
Musgrave, that ball should have been caught. Bob Brothers couldn't hang on.
Last year, as a national team, they might be ranked higher in the top five at this moment.
If they beat Washington next week, they will be up there. Believe me, here's a pass, and it's completed. Anthony Jones inside the 25-yard line. For Rich Brooks, a very fine coach. Probably the best unknown coach in the country. He's done such a good job at Oregon, but today is one of those games he'd just soon forget. Here's a pass completed to Brothers. He's knocked down at the 12, and the time has expired. The 45-7 win over Oregon. Bruce Snyder is down on the field, and coach, a thorough victory today.
Well, Gary, I really feel fortunate about that. It's a packed-in win, and we haven't been at home for a month, so it was nice to come back and be successful, although we know that we probably face an Oregon team that's, you know, struggling, and they've had some injury problems.
Well, you really now have positioned yourself to make a run at Washington in the Pac-10 title.
Well, I our plate is awfully full, I think, this week. The Huskies are awfully good, and we're just going to have to play a lot better than we did today, I think, to be with them.
One of the things, Bruce, this is Lynn Swan, I want to ask you about is, although the team played well, there are a lot of penalties in the game, and going against a good Washington team, you can't afford to have 16 penalties for 127 yards.
You know, Lynn, you're absolutely right. In fact, at halftime, I got after my team pretty good about that, and I'm just about ready to go back inside and talk again, because we're just not going to be able to play that way in a game like this coming week and hope to have any success.
How do you eliminate those kinds of mistakes?
Well, I don't know. You know, a lot of times it can be concentration, but I don't think that was the case today. My sense tells me maybe it's over-aggressiveness, because we played awfully hard today. I've got to compliment my team in that regard.
I think so, too, Bruce. You can't enjoy it very long, but congratulations, and I tell you, I'm just very impressed with your football team.
Well, thank you very much, and I don't think I've ever enjoyed coaching a team more than this one.
Thank you. Bruce Snyder with a win today. We'll be right back.